Good day, everyone. We're back with our special series on the Fair Credit Reporting Act. So far, we've heard how the Act seeks to regulate credit reporting. Thanks for tuning in again. I'm Noveline Brewster, and joining me today is attorney at law Sasha Shillingford, who's also a member of the working group that advised on the Act and a representative of the Barbados Bankers Association. Sasha will help us understand how the Act improves lending. Thank you so much, Sasha. It's a pleasure having you with us.
Thank you. Thank you for having me here. It's a pleasure to be here as well.
As I said in my introduction, we've already looked at the main tenets of this Act and how it will improve regulation of the credit reporting system in Barbados. So let us start by having you explain to us, how does it improve lending and the experience of borrowers in Barbados?
What it does is it certainly expands the nature of institutions providing information to a credit bureau. And it's important to know that credit bureaus are not new to Barbados. We've had two credit bureaus operating in Barbados for quite some time, and financial institutions have been using those credit bureaus to access information. The limiting factor has been the variety of credit information providers, so that it's mostly the financial institutions who are providing that information, and so the access to information or the breadth of information is limited. What this Act does is expand the types of entities that can provide information to a credit bureau. So it would include utilities, it would include your retailers, it can include landlords. If they wish to provide information, and if the central bank approves them as credit information providers. So it includes your government registries as well. So it is a much wider range of information, which then can provide a much more accurate picture of your borrower. And once you have a more accurate picture, what it does is reduces the risk to the lenders. And once risk is reduced, it means that lenders may not, for instance, require as much security or collateral security for loans. It increases the turnaround time of applying for credit. So there are many benefits to having a regulated system of credit information provided and access to credit scoring.
What would you say to those borrowers out there whose credit perhaps is subpar, and now you're having more information at your disposal to assess them, who may be fearful that, you know, I may even be less adequate for credit?
What I would say is that, I mean, for a long time, you know, we've had a system where, sadly, there are many borrowers who try to trick the system. They try to trick the lenders. They shop around. They go to different lenders and get loans. They go to retailers and take out credit, and they are unable to really manage those obligations. That has increased risk to anyone who's extending credit to any individual. And therefore, you know, to mitigate that risk, you have more stringent restrictions on accessing the credit. That works against everyone. It also doesn't work in favor of the borrower, because they find themselves eventually in financial trouble. They've overextended themselves and can't honor those obligations. So they have ended up with a poor or negative credit rating over time. But that situation has existed in spite of the Act. Lenders may not have lent to that individual based on the information they do have. And there are ways of getting information outside of the credit bureau. I mean, they would have information. There is a requirement to provide, fill out application forms. And at the end of the day, you can assess or determine what is the credit risk involved in lending. So it is, if you have had a poor credit history, chances are your lender may figure that out through the process in general outside of the credit bureau information that would have been available. So, I mean, what I would say to those persons is they're not only making it worse for the entire system and for everyone, because those stringent restrictions on accessing credit will be applicable across the board, as well as, you know, it is time to sort of maybe be a bit more responsible in terms of obtaining credit, managing your reputation as a borrower, and maybe focusing a little more on managing your financial affairs to ensure that you can turn around your credit history over time. If you need to approach your borrower and make arrangements to restructure all your debts, you can consolidate debts, and that can also impact positively on your credit rating. So there are ways, it sort of pushes people to be more responsible with their own financial affairs and to take action as quickly as possible to improve that score or to maintain a good score.
And under the system, the financial institutions, of course, are willing to work with such borrowers.
Yes, I mean, obviously, I'm not going to say that financial institutions are going to lend to persons who are very high risk. But of course, there is more to lending than simply a credit score. So that is one aspect of what goes into a credit decision. And there are many people who are, for all intents and purposes, have been good honoring their obligations over the years and may have run into some issue, some difficulty. It may not even be them. It could be that they're in a household and one family member who is an income earner has lost their job. The pandemic has caused that situation, and it's out of their control. So but it can impact their credit if they were reliant on that other family member, or they themselves have either had a salary cut. It may not be loss of a job. And it impacts their ability now to service their overall obligations. I mean, circumstances do change. Lenders will take that into consideration and they look at the overall picture. And that has always been the case.
Expand on the earlier point you made in relation to the regulation of the credit reporting system in Barbados actually accelerating the approval and disbursement of loans.
I mean, having a regulated credit bureau sector means that everything is streamlined. You know exactly what information is to be provided. You know what form it is to be provided. You know how it is to be kept. You know that it's going to be kept safely. So you have that comfort in providing the information. Credit bureaus are also set up to, they are set up to analyze that information very quickly. Their software and all the technology that they use is built for purpose to receive the information, keep it securely, and to generate an accurate credit picture of an individual. So having all of that regulated sort of it streamlines and makes the process much more efficient. It allows that picture of your borrower to be generated that much quicker, which means that the application and the lending process can be speeded up significantly.
We're going to switch now to this whole issue of the new system perhaps negating the need for collateral for some loans. Explain what are the benefits there by not having to provide this collateral, since you'll have your credit history and the credit score to rely on.
Collateral is just a method of mitigating risk for a bank. Every lender presents a risk, and the lender has to assess what is the level of risk that this particular borrower presents. And that determines then how much collateral security they're going to ask for, whether it be that you put up some property that you own as security, whether it be some other asset that is owned that the bank can hold, or it can be cash security as just security to ensure that if that person defaults, that the bank can recover the amount lent. So but assessing that risk, the risk increases with the less you know about the borrower. So where you have a credit bureau that is collecting information from all different areas, retailers, as I said, utilities, when you were paying rent for 10 years, did you pay on time? Did you pay your bills on time? Did you service your other loans on time? And you can get that quick picture of someone and you can see that they have a sparkling history. Even if they had a blip or two, the point is you can get a very quick picture of whether this person honors their financial obligations. There are many people who will take out a loan with no intention of repaying it. And it sort of weeds out those who really take their responsibilities very seriously. And once a lender feels that risk therefore is reduced, then they are no longer going to feel as dependent on having security or as much security at all. So they'll, in some cases, maybe they will feel comfortable asking for nothing in return, and they will be willing to give an unsecured loan just on the strength of that credit score and that credit history, or they may ask for less. And access to security is not always available to many borrowers. You know, not everybody owns property. Not everybody has a lot of assets that, can be taken by a lending institution. And it's very difficult nowadays to get a guarantor for a loan, because you know it means that that person now has to take on an obligation that is really not theirs, and that's a lot to ask of people. So where you remove that requirement, you certainly make accessing credit a lot easier.
To what extent, if any, would fair credit reporting reduce the cost of borrowing?
To a large extent, the price of borrowing is reduced where you remove that requirement for collateral security, because really a lot of the legal paperwork is connected to the taking of security. There's a lot more legal documents involved if you're going to take, if a lender is going to take some kind of interest in over a home that you may own or any form of asset. It is just a lot more complex, and there are going to be government fees associated with putting that security in place. And therefore, all of that is borne by the borrower. So if you can remove all of those costs, particularly legal costs, which I think everybody is quite familiar with, can get quite high, then certainly the overall price of lending or borrowing is reduced.
Sasha, one of the recurring concerns is this whole issue of how do the financial institutions protect my information? Mm-hmm. Put our viewers at ease as to how you will go about making sure that there are no breaches in people's information that is shared with you.
Certainly, any lending institution has long been subject to the law of customer confidentiality. So securing customers' information is not new to lenders. Certainly, the newer laws that have come into play, like the Data Protection Act and the Fair Credit Reporting Act, do strengthen and make it clearer how that information is to be kept and how to secure it so that there are no breaches or leaks of that information, particularly information that is considered very sensitive, such as financial information. From the lender's side, you know, the procedures, policies are already in place. The technology is already in place to ensure that information is secured, both from a technology standpoint as well as from the staff standpoint, how they handle that information. In terms of securing when you provide that information to a third party, like a credit bureau, the Fair Credit Reporting Act does specify in particular what information is to be supplied to that credit bureau, how it is to be supplied, the technological format that is to be provided in, how it is to be kept, how long it is to be kept, you know, the type of information that can be provided. Certainly it excludes sensitive personal information such as, you know, your political affiliation, anything that is really not connected to the credit decision, sexual orientation, religious orientation, whether you have a criminal record. Those things are considered highly sensitive and not directly related to a credit information, and the Act actually prevents a financial institution from supplying that information to a credit bureau. So it is very clear on how that information is to be treated. And I will say that in the licensing regime of a credit bureau, they also have to be assessed to ensure that the procedures, that the technology, that the all the safeguards are there before they can even get a license to take on people's information and keep it.
What new opportunities, if any, do you see this Act presenting for borrowers and lenders?
Well, I'll start with the borrowers. I think it prevents a great opportunity to take control of how you are perceived by credit providers. certainly, as I said, there is a level of uncertainty as to what information, even when a credit decision is made, you might be turned down for a loan. You really are not sure exactly why you may be turned down. Yes, the lender may tell you, you know, what their reason is, but it certainly presents an opportunity for persons to really understand the details that go into that decision. And I did say that there were other things that do factor into that. But having access to what information is kept in your credit history is really critical to someone to know that that is accurate information. You have the opportunity to correct that information if it is not accurate. You know, errors are always made in holding information. Once information is being entered by human beings, they can make errors, or there may just be an oversight in updating that information. So you may have something on your record that has been already addressed and you need that corrected. So it certainly provides an opportunity to take control of it, of what, you know, how you are perceived across the entire credit landscape, which is retailers, you know, your utility providers, and understand better how they are going about making decisions about your development, your life, and certainly also to ensure that maybe if there are actions that you can take to improve that perception, that you can do so.
Before you answer the question about the opportunities for the lenders, explain how, by approaching creditors as soon as they run into difficulties, borrowers can improve how financial institutions perceive them.
Well, you know, the longer you wait, where you see a situation arising, it doesn't have to have even materialized yet. So, for instance, you know that you've been given a couple months notice that you are, you know, you're going to lose your job. You know, and you know that down the road you have this mortgage payment or loan payment coming up, and that is going to impact your ability to pay that loan. Instead of waiting until the arrears happens, the interest bills on the arrears, and that mounts to such a level where it is now impossible to really try to get it back under control, it is better to come into the bank early, explain the situation, lay your cards on the table, and the bank will, you know, usually a lending institution will work with you to try to get you back on track. I mean, in the pandemic, you would have seen moratoriums being extended by lending institutions on interest payments, as well as, you know, loans can be restructured where they can be extended, the period of the loan can be extended, which reduces your monthly payment. So there are ways you can consolidate all your debt. If you have them spread out across different institutions, you can come to the bank. The bank can say, I will lend you, pay off all of these debts, and then you have one payment which is manageable to deal with that situation. So it is really critical to work with your lender as opposed to wait too long and then the, you know, the amount owed becomes insurmountable.
And what are the potential benefits there down the road for your credit history and credit score?
Certainly that can keep your score on track, keep it good if it is good, and if it is starting to go in the wrong direction, it can certainly turn it around.
And for the
lenders, right? It creates an opportunity, I think, for lenders to improve the whole credit making decision, improve relationships with customers. You know, sometimes that application to get a loan, you know, you submit your application and then it can take a while for you and to actually get approved, maybe even get a decision, even if it's negative. And certainly, you know, it is within lenders' interests to increase, to improve that turnaround time, ensure that people know very early up, you know, whether they are going to get access to the credit or not, and certainly to actually access the credit. So to be able to cut down that time is really a great opportunity. Also, it presents, credit bureaus are not just providers of credit scores and credit reports. They have so much information that they can, you know, lenders can actually access statistical information that shows behaviors of lenders without identifying anyone in particular. They can show, you can develop products that are actually more attractive to persons based on how you observe the analysis that goes into how borrowers behave, maybe what income brackets they fall into, who borrows the most, who repays the best, because it is not always what you expect. You know, there's a lot of assumption that goes into it, but when you have hard data that really can capture this and you can use it to customize products, it can be very, very beneficial to a financial institution.
Indeed, and as the saying goes now, data is like oil, and we all know throughout the years how important it is to have strong relationships in financial institutions between themselves and their customers. Thank you so much. Any final message for our viewers, Sasha? Anything else you would like to say?
I want to just say that I think you know, the public should embrace the Act. I think it is a great structured framework for managing your own information, and people should get to know what information is held by the credit bureau. Get familiar with the Act, get familiar with their rights under the Act. You know, it's a great opportunity to manage your own information, ensure that what is held is accurate, that it's up to date. Also to change the perception of you as a borrower. So I say embrace it and certainly take advantage of the opportunities it does present in terms of accessing credit, which there is a direct correlation to access to credit and ease of access to credit and development. So if lenders can turn around credit very quickly, the public can only benefit in their own development, in their children's development. So I say embrace the Act in all that it has to offer.
Thank you. It was an absolute delight having this conversation with you. And thank you for tuning in. Hit the buttons below to like and share this episode. And see you next time.